If people were to think of conflict situations in my country 50 years ago, I would think of the Nigerian Biafra War, the Civil War. If you think of it 10 years ago, it would be the Niger Delta militancy. And then 3 years back, it's Boko Haram. Many of us here got to know of that when the schoolgirls in this community called Chibok in Borno State were kidnapped by Boko Haram. This made headlines, and the Bring Back Our Girls campaign made headlines and mobilized people around the world around it. But what most people do not know is that in terms of frequency of attacks and the number of lives that are lost due to reprisal attacks, Boko Haram is no more the biggest challenge that we face in our country. It is conflict and violence within and between our communities in our country. This photo you see here was taken when we visited a community called Bakin Kogi in southern Kaduna last week, Tuesday, February 21. 2 days earlier, that was two nights actually earlier, gunmen attacked this community. Many lives were lost, properties were destroyed. This is a reality that many communities are dealing with in some of our communities. And so, whether it is the Fulani herdsmen or farmers conflict, or whether it's post-election violence, like the one we had post-2011 in our country, most of these conflicts are driven along the lines of identity, be it religious, ethnic, and tribal. And so changing attitudes and behaviors that drive identity-based conflicts is exactly what the One Family Under God campaign is about. So we are helping people to be able to remove stereotypes they have about others so that they can be able to see the humanity in the other person. And so, though the campaign was launched in 2013 during the Global Peace Leadership Conference in Abuja, Nigeria, we began piloting this in one of the states, Kaduna State, which is one of our 36 states. We began with 6 communities in Kaduna and later added another 6. Over the past 1 year plus, this pilot program has been going on in these 12 communities. What we do is that when a community is selected, we first visit the traditional ruler of the community to share our plans with the traditional ruler. When we get the buy-in of this traditional ruler, then the next thing is he mobilizes key stakeholders of his community for a 1-day preliminary sensitization of the community stakeholders. When that happens, next, the community nominates 8 persons to represent them in a statewide training of trainers and capacity building workshop, 3 days. These 8 persons, always 2 women leaders, 2 youth leaders, 2 religious leaders, and 2 community traditional rulers. And it's always a combination of a Muslim and a Christian for each of these communities. And so, at the end of the statewide training of trainers, a 3-day capacity building workshop and training of trainers, we then work with these 8 persons to be able to organize another one day capacity building workshop in their community for 40 other persons in their local community. We are doing this, we are in the business of raising honors of the vision. And so, these persons go on to take ownership of this message, of our message of one family under God, and use this to transform their community by reaching out to others, and also forming themselves into a group of stakeholders that engage in mediation and other conflict resolution practices within their community. And so, while this process is a long one and is ongoing, the question we ask ourselves now is, are we making progress? Are we having some results? Well, the best people to ask are the people of the community. And so I want you to go with me now. Let's go to the community and ask some of the persons in this community. Are we ready to go? Okay, let's go there.
Sunana, Miss Grace Gaius. Na sai da magunguna ne ana. Ba zan manta 211 election ba. Lokacin mun samu tashin hankali. Bimin lokacin na samu shago na an kone mun kayaki na. Lokacin na kuma ba ma zaman lafiya. Duk inda ka saifin kafanka za ci kai ba dan gari bane. Mun samu na masala din. Amma kan zuwon ku kun waye mana da kai. Kun sa idanun mu ya bude yanzu. Mun ga da cewa to asali mu da mu a can mu zuriya daya ne. Gaskiya yanzu kam mun fi amfana yanzu. Domin da can farko ina da ra'ayin zuwa garin nan. Amma daga baya yanzu ni nake cema wa dansu ma ku da dusa waya dadi fidan da kuke tunani yanzu.
Gaskiya yanzu in an ce in jaraba sai in ce yanzu mun fi da samun zama lafiya. Kafin wannan kungiya ta zo idan muka ji kwaram sai ka ji muna ce ma yara ku je ku leko lafiya kuwa. Amma yanzu ba ma tunanin wannan.
There are places here in Sabon Gari that the Christian will dare not go there because of we are sometimes afraid of attacks by the Muslims and likewise the Muslims. But after the campaign, I came to realize that we don't have any no-go area. We don't have it here in Sabon Gari.
Ba shakka wannan kungiya na iya tunawa sun zo sun mana kamar workshop kenan. Sun yi mana bayani akan haɗin kai da kuma neman a dawo domin a ci gaba da zaman lafiya. Kafin zuwan akwai matsaloli na damuwa abu ya faru ba wani ma wanda ya zo iya baka hakuri bare ka ji daɗi amma zuwansu ya kawo mana fahimta ya kawo mana jin daɗi kuma ya hasasa yanda har mun ci gaba da kiraye-kiraye ga mutanenmu da ya yi hakuri wanda Allah ya ba shi ikon dawowa ya dawo kuma hakan ɗin ya ɗan taimaka wasu sun fara yarda da wannan kira.
When they came down to our place here, when we had this sensitization, in fact, our eyes were opened on certain things. We come to know that we are all from one God and we shall all return to one God. That is to say that God does not have any discrimination to any body, race, tribe, and what have you, because we are all from Him. That is. People come to say that, okay, then if that is the case, why is it that we should hate one another?
Kafin ai wannan taro da awaye da mu, za ga musulmi ya kalli Kirista wani iri, Kirista ya kalli musulmi wani iri. To amma wannan haɗuwa da muke yi muna wayar da kan juna, za ga muna ta fara juna. Ga ka faɗa na ga na Kirista ya uwa na mace.
I can cite up to 3 people. Of which they left here without their family and everything, but they have came back again to start their own normal business.
People were bitter against one another. People were against one another. But with this kind of simple message coming in, your attention is changed gradually. And people are beginning to understand and embracing peace, dialogue.
So for us, as Martin Luther King said, we either learn to live together as brothers or perish together as fools. So the One Family Under God campaign is helping our communities, not so that we don't perish together as fools, but live together as brothers and sisters, in fact, as members of one family under God. And before I step down from here, because my time is already running out, I know that when I finish this presentation, you will want to give a round of applause for me, but that would be misplaced. I didn't say you should give a round of applause to me. I said you will want to. So, but that would be misplaced. So, there are, as far as this ongoing efforts that we are carrying out in these communities are concerned, there are three persons that I know are the ones who deserve the round of applause that you will want to give me at the end of this presentation. Yesterday, you already gave a round of applause to two of them, Reverend Joseph Hayab and Sheikh Haliru Maraya. The third person is the unseen hero for me and the driver, the pillar for Global Peace Foundation Nigeria, who continues to be our pillar. The wife of the former Vice President of Nigeria, the Grand Patron of Global Peace Foundation Nigeria, Her Excellency Amina Namadi Sambo. Please give her a round of applause. Thank you. So you will no more need to give me any round of applause. Please give it to them. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Okoh.